method that we are using in the Minecraft project is a method that is used to model how things deform, and it's called smooth particle hydrodynamics. I basically just gave that code to that group of students to try to get it to work in Minecraft.
I don't remember when Minecraft came out, but I remember I was like little and I've been playing it since then, and I've never like made a mod for it. When this came up to get to learn how to do that and learn a new programming language, I was very excited for that. As a group, we would define a task if we want them to build this bridge, and then I would kind of set up a world that each student would load into, and then they'd kind of go from there. We've added a few new blocks to the game. So the first one, the Topolium block, it'll color the blocks either by stress or by deflection. From lowest to highest, kind of the purple is the least amount of stress, and then the red is going to be the highest. The first one we did was that desert one where you could use a support in the middle, and then on this one, we didn't give that option.
And then it was kind of surprising to see when you give it to students that had not played with it, they would just come up with completely different solutions. We got to see real time their first approach and then maybe how they would refine it as they played more.
Watching the students use it, and then especially in the beginning, seeing how they would break it, then our next challenge would be how can we make it unbreakable, being able to make changes to make it better. That whole process, I think, was my favorite part of it.
That type of program that is open-ended rather than what you usually do in the classroom where you have to, you know, you get something very specific and it's just one solution and it's right or wrong. They really helped me thinking through problems that are open-ended where students can do wild approaches and get different solutions, and some will fail, some will work. So then you can easily see, you can get this instant visual feedback. And then ideally, when you build something, it clicks. And so if you say, oh, you know, when I build it like this, it breaks. But when I build it in this other way, it doesn't break. That makes sense because that's what I learned in class.
It was really awesome. It just makes you think about what the problem is and what the best way to solve it is. Thank you.